President of the International Fund for Agricultural Development, Mr. Gilbert Hongbo, distinguished ministers, excellencies, ladies and gentlemen. It is a pleasure to be invited to speak to IFAD Governing Council. Agriculture is central to human survival. IFAD has made a significant contribution to enhancing agricultural production in the developing countries. Today, the world confronts a looming agricultural crisis. The global population will soon reach 8 billion people. 600 million suffer from hunger. Over 100 million children are stunted due to undernourishment. Unfortunately, the COVID-19 pandemic is likely to push another 100 million people into extreme poverty. Over 20 countries are food insecure. The World Food Programme has warned of the danger of famine in some of the poorest countries and conflict zones. The world faces multiple challenges in recovering from the pandemic and achieving vital first two sustainable development goals: no poverty and zero hunger. There is lack of financing, shortage of investment, trade distortions, unsustainable production and consumption patterns, degradation of agricultural lands and forests, an impending water crisis, loss of biodiversity and polluted rivers and oceans. We need a revolution in our vision of our future. The COVID-19 pandemic and the climate crisis should drive home the message to all, rich and poor, weak or powerful, that their destinies are intertwined. We will perish or survive together. The concepts of geostrategic adversaries, of regional or global domination, of the political advantages of foreign intervention and occupation, and the oppression of peoples are outdated and will soon be seen as irrelevant. We need a common plan and strategy for global recovery and survival and prosperity of all humanity. In response to the recession triggered by the COVID-19 crisis, I proposed a global initiative on debt relief last April. The debt suspension announced by the G20 and the emergency lending programs of the World Bank, IMF, and others have provided some breathing space. But according to the latest estimates, the developing countries need $4.3 trillion to recover from the pandemic and achieve the SDGs. Last December, at the special session of the UN General Assembly, I proposed several measures for generation of early financing to enable developing countries' recovery from the COVID-19 crisis. These steps include comprehensive debt relief and restructuring, the creation of $500 million in SDRs, larger concessional financing, and measures to halt and recover illicit financial flows from developing countries to haven destinations and to richer countries. But if we are to end poverty and hunger, we will need to go much further. I propose a five-point agenda. First, we need to invest in sustainable agriculture infrastructure to facilitate transport, production and distribution of agricultural inputs and food products. The green lanes created by China are a good example. Second, governments need to more actively ensure adequate and fair prices for agricultural and food products. The so-called magic of the marketplace should be balanced with the very visible hand of the state. We in Pakistan have suffered from market manipulations by monopolists and hoarders. Farmers should not be left to the mercy of the corporations. At the same time, international agricultural trade must be rationalized. The huge agricultural subsidies provided by certain richer economies distort global markets and make it impossible for farmers in the developing countries to compete. Third, the new and breakthrough agricultural technologies and techniques must be consciously applied to enhance food production, ensure efficient usage of water and land, and above all, improve seed quality. IFAD and the FAO can play a major role in this context. Fourth, the adoption of digital technologies is as vital in agriculture as in other economic sectors. Ensuring internet and broadband access to the rural areas will be vital for their integration into national and global supply chains. Fifth, and perhaps the most important, we must rethink our patterns of food consumption and production. We can eat better, and many of us would do well to eat less. We can produce food with greater respect for nature. We can stop the pollution of our lakes, rivers, and oceans. We can produce more with less water and without dangerous chemicals. I further propose that a new strategy for sustainable food production and consumption should be considered and adopted at the Food Systems Summit next year. Excellencies, in Pakistan, we have integrated the Sustainable Development Goals into our National Development Plan. My government has accorded the highest priority to achieve SDG 1, which is no poverty, and SDG 2, zero hunger. Despite our financial difficulties, during the COVID-19 pandemic, we provided a relief package of around $8 billion. It included emergency cash assistance to the poorest families and other vulnerable groups, including women and children. We did so through our ESSAS program, which means compassion, fully utilizing digital technologies and databases. This was the largest poverty alleviation program in Pakistan's history. Agriculture sector, which had to grapple with the twin challenges of COVID-19 and locust attacks, which we were subjected to last year. But it continues to have my utmost attention. Budgetary allocation has been increased almost three times. Growth target for the current year has been set at 3.5%. We are also engaged in one of the largest reforestation programs in the world. We plan to plant 10 billion trees over the next 3 years. We will also set aside 8 large areas as national reserves or national parks. Under the China-Pakistan Economic Corridor, agricultural modernization has been included as a vital element of our development strategy. This will move us significantly towards combating hunger and poverty. Excellencies, the national efforts of developing countries like Pakistan to promote sustainable development and eliminate poverty and hunger can only succeed through international cooperation. We desire such cooperation with all countries. We greatly admire the role played by IFAD in promoting such cooperation. I wish you all the success in the important deliberations of your current session. I thank you.